A staple of many Hangout worlds is a darkness slider. Here's how you can make one. To create the darkness effect, we need to create a post-processing volume. In order for a post-processing volume to work, however, we need to first come up to our main camera and add a post-processing layer. So add component, post-processing layer. We need to change the layer that it's affecting to one that we're not using, in my case, water. Then head over to the hierarchy, right-click and click create empty. I'm going to name this empty post-processing and change its layer to the same one as the post-processing layer that we just created. We then want to go add component, post-processing, volume. Set is global to true. And then we want to create a new profile. Go add effect, unity, color grading. And to create a simple darkness effect, we want to enable post-exposure. And then lower this value to set the max darkness for our slider. With this done, when we change the weight, we will change how dark the scene is. Now we just need a way of changing the weight value. We can do this via an animation. To create an animation, we can go window, animation, animation. I'm going to park this down next to my console, and then I'm going to hit create animation. I'm going to name mine darkness slider animation. I'm going to come over here and hit the record button, and I'm then going to set the weight to 0. I'm then going to drag along the timeline to the 1 second mark, and I'm going to drag the weight over to 1 as well. Now when we play, we should see it go from light to dark. However, if you look at the weight, you'll see that it's not consistent. To make this more linear, we want to select all our nodes, right click, go both tangents linear. And now we can see the weight moves linearly instead of what it was doing before. Okay, I'm going to stop previewing. And then it's time to control this animation. Go under Window, Animation, Animator. And we can see our animation right here. I'm going to change its speed to 0. And I'm going to change its cycle offset to a parameter. We don't have a parameter right now, so it's giving us an error. So we can come over to here to parameters, go plus float. And I'm going to call this darkness float. We can see that the animator picked up our darkness float parameter. So now all that's left is to test this. We can do this by pressing play in Unity. And once it's loaded in, I'm going to park my animator below my game window. And now when I change this float value, it should change the darkness of the scene. Something to note, however, if I press 1, it won't do max brightness. Instead, it will go to 0, essentially. And if I go 0.9999, that is the maximum darkness instead of 1. This will come into play later on. Now we can stop playing Unity. And now it's time to create the UI slider that the player will interact with. We're going to right click here, go UI canvas. And there are some stuff we need to change here. We want to change layer to walkthrough. We want to change screen space from overlay to world space. We want to add component UI shape. And then we need to change its transform. I'm going to change its scale to 0.005, 0.005, and the Z to something really small. I'm then going to change its width to 180, 120. And then I'm just going to do a quick fly and go Control Shift F to place it where I am. I'm going to right click on the hierarchy and go UI slider. And then I'm going to reset its transform, just a quick 0, 0. Now for the slider, we need to change navigation to none, so it doesn't get affected by our joysticks or arrow keys. We want to change its max value to 0.9999, and this will mean when the player maxes out the darkness, it doesn't set it to 1, which as far as the animator is considered, it is the same as 0. And then we need to create an Udon behavior component to change the animator float to whatever the slider is set to. We could hit new program, but to be more neat and tidy, I'm going to go into my project. I'm going to right click, go create VRChat Udon Udon graph program, and I'm going to call this darkness slider. And then I'm going to open the Udon graph. Inside the Udon graph, I'm going to right click create node. The shortcut is spacebar for this. I'm going to go animator. And now we can see everything we can do with the animator, to which I'm going to go set float. This set float node requires 3 things, a animator, an ID, and a value. I want to use a string name instead of an ID, so I'm going to click this drop down menu and hit string instead. And then we need to create variables for all 3 of these. I'm going to just expand my variables windows and hit plus animator. I then also need a string as well as a slider. I'm going to give these simple names of anim, short for animator. I'm then going to call the string anim float name. And I'm just going to call the slider slider. I'm then going to hit these drop down menus and make all of them public. This means that we'll be able to select them inside the inspector and tell it which sliders we want to use and whatnot. And now I can drop my animator into the animator slot, my animator float name into the string slot. And for the slider, I'm going to drag it in. Now it's a slider, not a float that is required for the set float node. But we can go create node UI slider and go get value. And then it's simply a case of joining the dots. Now we need to say when we want it to change the float value. To do that, we're going to make a custom event. And I'm going to call this change darkness. And we're going to drag the arrow into the arrow slot. And now whenever this event is called, it will update the float value inside the animator. Now we go back to our slider, drag and drop our new Udon script into the Udon behavior. And now it's time to fill in our public variables. The animator was on our post-processing game object. The slider is ourself, so we can drag and drop that on there. And then the float name, if we come back to the animator, we can just double click on this, Control C, Control V. It is case sensitive. Now all we need to do is call this custom event. To do so, we hit the little plus on our slider. We drag and drop our slider game object into the object. Under no function, we hit Udon behavior and send custom event. We then want to grab the name of the custom event and paste that in. And now that's all that's left is to test this. Now that we're in the game, when we move the slider, we should see the brightness of the world change. So hopefully that's been helpful for you. Give it a like if you liked the video, dislike if you disliked it, and be sure to give that comment section some love down below. Until next time, bye!